you once again. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. As said, I'm going to read from the book of Genesis 12, verse 2 to 3. The Bible says, I will make of you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you and curse who curses you. And in you, all family of the heart will be blessed. The Bible says, this is what the promise God made with Abraham. He said that he would make him great. Great, great, great nation, and they will bless him. Verse 3 says, I will bless them who bless you and curse who curses you. So here is a condition that Abraham was given to anybody who would try to curse him. As a child of God, anybody will curse you. The Lord himself will curse him. And the Bible says, and in you, all the family of the earth will be blessed. Thank you, Jesus. So in you, that's the Bible says. The Bible says, in you, all the families of the earth will be blessed. You are among the blessings of Abraham. You are among the blessings of Abraham. The blessings of Abraham are yours. So this is the blessings that God promised you. God has promised that he will bless you according the way he blesses Abraham. So his blessings will fall upon you. That's what the Bible says. Now, the Bible declares that anybody who will curse you will be cursed in the name of Jesus. That's why we are going to deal with the curses. We are going to break with the curses, that any curse that has been blessed on you shall be destroyed and break into pieces in Jesus' name. I'm going to read from the book of Psalms 37, verse 25 to 26. The Bible says, in the book of Psalms 37, verse 25 to 26, the Bible says, I was young and now I am old, yet I've never seen the righteous forsaken or their children begging bread. They are always generously and render freely. Their children will be a blessing. Now here, the Bible is saying, David was young and now is old. He has never seen the righteous forsaken or their children begging bread. Yeah? David is saying that the righteous child or the righteous person will never beg bread to eat. Now we are begging. We are begging bread. You see, our children are begging bread. We are begging bread. The poverty that has come to us has made us to be a beggar. We are begging. Yeah? We are not flowing in the blessings of Abraham that God has promised us. We are not in that blessing. That's why we are struggling so hard. That's why we cannot have enough. The Bible says they are always generously and lend freely. Their children will be a blessing. So this is a promise. But here now, we are struggling so much. We are living in poverty, including the people living in USA, America, Canada, and in Europe, and places where the Bible describe like a place of honey and milk. This is opportunity, a country where it helps other countries. It helps a lot of money, billions, thousands of dollars. They are helping other countries. And the citizen, the very citizen living in the country, they are struggling with the heavy traffic of poverty. I am going to break this poverty. Poverty is a great enemy. The Bible says poverty is an enemy of God. So poverty is a great enemy to you and to your family. In the name of Jesus, the Bible said, David has said that he has never seen. Yes? Now, since David says, you see, people are following. People are begging. They go to the banks and beg money. They go and borrow everywhere. They are living in poverty, which means that as a child of God, as David described here, he has never seen it is. But now, there are so many people right now living under that poverty level. I am praying that enemies of your life, enemies that make you poor, enemy that is responsible for your prosperity, enemy that is sitting on your prosperity, enemy that is sitting on your wealth, let them catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. I break the powers of poverty in your life in the name of Jesus. Tonight, I destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Psalms 112 verse 1 to 4, the Bible says, praise the Lord, how blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commandment. His descendants will be mighty on earth. The generations of upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches are in his house, and his righteousness endure forever. Light rises in the darkness of the upright. He is generous and compassionate and righteous. The Bible is saying that if you fear the Lord, this is what the Bible says, who greatly delight in the commandment of God. The Bible says, his descendants will be might on earth. Now, our forefather, what they did fear the Lord. They did fear the Lord. So because they didn't fear the Lord, now we are endure. We are carrying the curses of poverty because they didn't fear God. Now the Bible says, if you fear the Lord, wealth and riches are in his house, and his righteous endure forever. I pray and declare, because God is able, that God who does not change, who promised that the riches and wealth will be in the house, I pray that the wealth and riches will be in your house, will be in your house forever in the mighty name of Jesus. Because you fear the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, it doesn't matter whether your forefathers believed God or not. You are a different person. When the enemy is using what your forefather did, let this enemy be destroyed and bind to business in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every generation of curses that is following you, that is attacking your prosperity, that is attacking your money, that is attacking your finances, let this power be destroyed in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God Almighty, I command thunder. I command the thunder of God to break into pieces all the satanic arrows of poverty fired into your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I declare and declare by the power in the blood of Jesus, let the thunder of God to break to pieces all satanic arrows of poverty fired into your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let thunder brought of God, let thunder and the fire of God, thunder the demon that is responsible for your wealth, that is holding you backward, that is holding you captivity, that is taking advantage of you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every foundational arrow of poverty be removed by fire in the name of Jesus. I pray for you. I pray every foundational of arrows of poverty be removed by fire in the name of Jesus. I cast out, I pray every foundation of poverty be removed by fire in the name of Jesus. I destroy you, poverty. I destroy you, enemy of poverty. That you are living this life of this person. I destroy them in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I paralyze all inherited arrows of poverty. Every arrows of inherited arrows of poverty in your life, I destroy them. I bind them and I render them powerless. They would not manifest in the name of Jesus. I destroy them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. You will not help poverty. Poverty in this life, poverty in your life, I destroy them. I bind them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. Father Lord, shield. I pray that let Father God to shield you. Any arrow of of poverty fired against you, against your life, against your family, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let God be shelled. Let God shield every arrows of poverty fired against you, against your life, against your family, in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my God, I want to thank you, Lord. Every gate of poverty, roast to ashes in the name of Jesus. I pray every gate of poverty, roast to ashes in Jesus' name. There is gate of poverty. Gate of poverty that is it's getting you. You cannot achieve anything. You can't get anything. You can't have anything. Therefore, I pray by the power in the blood of Jesus, let this gate catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Thank you, my Father. Hallelujah, God. Every instrument of failure working against your advancement, I command you to fail in the name of Jesus. Every instrument of failure working against your advancement, I command you to fail in Jesus' name. There are instruments of failure. The instrument of failure in your life, whatever you try, everything you will fail. Because the instrument of failure has blessed on you. Therefore, I bring that instrument, I command them to catch fire. To catch fire, to burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Every instrument of failure in your life, when the instrument of failure has been pressed by evil, by Satan, by witchcraft into your life, no matter you what you do, you will still fail. Even if they ask you 2 plus 2 is 4, you will write 3 or you write 6. You can't always get the answer. You always miss something. When other people are getting 100 over 100, you are getting 40, 50. You always miss, or you get 90, 99, you miss one, then that is it. A dear sister was sharing to me this. She was doing a test that she was going to get her license. She missed one mark, and then that was it. When you have the instrument of failure in your life, no matter, whenever you anything you do, you will be failure. You can go to the test, you do very well, everything is correct, then one thing will make you to fail. We will make a mistake that will make you fail. So they will see that you are not serious. Therefore, I destroy that instrument of failure in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Let every evil decree working against your life, your potential, be revoked, be revoked, be revoked in the name of Jesus. Be revoked in the name of Jesus. Let every evil decree working against your potential be revoked in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will deal with every degree working against your potential. You are so potential, but the enemy knows this, and he has a degree that your potential will be wasted. Let the enemy be destroyed tonight. I curse you. I break every curse that you have issues against the life of this person by the power and the blood of Jesus. I remove by fire every mark of poverty in your life. I remove by fire every mark of poverty. Every mark of poverty, I remove you. I remove you by fire. I remove you by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. I remove you by fire. I destroy you. You powers of poverty, I destroy you in the name of Jesus. Get out of this person. Because David says he was young. Now he was young. Now he's old. He has never seen a righteous child, a righteous person begging bread, a righteous person being abandoned or being second, or his child begging bread. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will not beg food to eat. You will not beg money. You will be the lender. You will be the head. You will never be a beggar anymore. You will never be under that begging. You go to beg your bank. You go to bank, beg ATM. You will not do that. God Almighty will deliver you. The blessings of Abraham will fall upon you and it will overtake you. According to the book of Deuteronomy 28, verse 1 to 15, the blessing that of the book of Deuteronomy 28, verse 1 to 15, it will fall upon you and overtake you, and you will not have a place to keep it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, I am praying for your business. If you are a person who is want to start business, or you are in business, I pray that let your business reject every mark of poverty in the name of Jesus. Let your business reject every mark of poverty in the mighty name of Jesus. I break and loose you, future, your finances, and your health through the domination of witchcraft powers in the name of Jesus. I loose your future and your finances and your health from domination of witchcraft power in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I break and destroy, and I break and destroy every curses of for your finances and your health from domination of witchcraft power in the name of Jesus. Every evil hand that colored you when you was a baby, I command them to be roasted. Evil hands that when you are a baby, when they picked you and say something about you, let those hands be weathered in the mighty name of Jesus. Even when you were named, the name you are being named, maybe that name is a curse itself. Is it denying the rights from receiving the blessings of God? Let that hand be weathered in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, you mountain of dead, programs to put you unto poverty, be cast away in the name of Jesus. Let it be cast away in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, I pray that God, you will recover your placenta from the gate of wicked people in the name of Jesus. Maybe your placenta is being taken and used against you, that you will never get anything. You will never be rich. You will never have anything, God. You don't know your placenta where it is. Because I've said to you many times, placenta is the biggest market in the world. If you know where your placenta is and what your placenta is doing, wicked people, they take the placenta and they take your wealth from your placenta. That's why the placenta is very, 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 very important. In the back home, they take it. If they take it and you have no idea what they do with your placenta. Witchcraft, they eat it. Witchcraft, they do evil against your placenta. In the hospital here in USA, Canada, wherever, go and check where your placenta is. You will find your placenta where it is somewhere. It is kept somewhere. And you don't know whether it's there or witchcraft have taken it. Therefore, I pray that anything connected with your placenta that is holding you poverty, that's making you to poor, let that placenta catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. Receive divine direction. I pray that you will receive divine direction. God will show you the direction that you will follow to start a business, to get a divine job that will benefit you, that will give you income. You will not suffer anymore. You've been suffered enough. You've been a beggar. You have been suffering. You have been miserable living that life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I am setting fire against every poverty demon working against you. You demon of poverty, get out of this person. Get out. I curse you. I curse you by the power of the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says wealth and riches will never depart from the house. Therefore, I decree and declare by the power of the blood of Jesus that wealth and riches will be in my house, in your house, in my house and in your house, in the name of Jesus, because you are a child of God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. Oh, God, arise and disgrace every drop of poverty in your family, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, God, arise and scatter every drop of poverty in your life, in Jesus' name. Supernatural ideas that generate prosperity, let it rocket you today, in the name of Jesus. Let supernatural ideas that generate prosperity rocket you today, in the name of Jesus. Let supernatural ideas that generate prosperity rocket you today, in the name of Jesus. Your life will not be the same again, in the mighty name of Jesus. Your life will move to the next level. You will not be a beggar. You will not be struggling anymore. You will live by the blessings of Abraham. That's what the Bible says. God says the family of the earth will be blessed because of you. The family of the earth. You are the family of the earth. You are the family of Abraham. You have the blessings of Abraham belongs to you. Therefore, receive the blessings of Abraham. You will never live under poverty again. Abraham was not rich, but God made him rich, very rich. He became very wealthy. When God called Abraham, he told him, move, go, and I will bless you and curse wherever I will curse you. The Lord has called you, has set you free. He has called you from the bondage. He has called you from poverty. Why are you still living in poverty? I destroy that power because God has blessed you, but you have no idea. Therefore, every blessing that enemy sitting on your blessings, let this enemy be destroyed. You wicked personality, you witchcraft power, sitting on your wealth, sitting on your prosperity, let them catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you. Jesus, I worship you. Jesus, I honor you. I give you all the glory. Loving Father, you are great God. Thank you, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I honor you, my God. Yes, my Father, I thank you, Jesus. I worship you, God. I honor you, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. I destroy and bind out. I destroy and bind out every power of poverty that is working against your life, that is working against your children, that is working against your family. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am coming against witchcraft poverty affecting your life. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. This time, around this time, you are overcomers. You are overcomers. The Lord will turn your circumstances around you to favor you in the mighty name of Jesus. Poverty, I am calling you by the power in the blood of Jesus. Get out of this person. Get out and out in the name of Jesus. I bind you. I send you a blessing in Jesus' name. Get out. No more people begging. No more people suffering. No more children of Abraham suffering. No more being attacked by poverty. Let this poverty get out from your life. Let this poverty get out from your family. Let this poverty get out from your blood, your bloodline. I destroy them and I crush them and I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. From tonight, all of the morning, whatever time is in your country, you are free from demon of poverty. You are free from powers of poverty. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will excel, you will prosper. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus, my God and my Father. I want to thank you once again. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca, and see if we have so much materials there. And also, if you want to become a partner to us, go and request. There's a request there, a prayer request. Like there, say, I want to become a partner. And you will be covered. You will benefit a lot of stuff that partners are benefit. I will be able to send. Okay, the website is www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. That is a website. You can go there and request. If you want me to pray with you, you can always call me. Our number is 6. That is a cell phone. 647-608-5207. This is our number, a cell phone number. You can text me. You can send a text message. Or you can WhatsApp. If you are on WhatsApp, if you are not anywhere global, you can always reach me by texting. You start with +1 647-608-5207. That is our number. You can text me, you can call me. I will pray with you and help you and stand with you. You need a cover. If you are looking for a cover, if you are looking for a spiritual parent, if you are looking for someone to cover you, I will cover you. Therefore, people of God, you are not alone. You are our family. You are our member. You are a member of Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. You are one of our family. So welcome. Don't be alone. Don't fight by yourself. Join us and let us fight together. One two people will chase thousands of enemies. So you are not alone. You are not alone anymore. Join us and let us fight this war in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. I love you so much. See you tomorrow. Today it was delayed a little bit, but all in all, I am here with you. Tomorrow will be better. I thank you, prayer line. Sorry you was late, but nevertheless, delay is not a denial. So the blessings of Abraham is still yours. Therefore, I thank you so much. I love you so much. I see you tomorrow at the same time, midnight, 12 midnight. Tomorrow, 12 midnight. Invite your followers, invite your friends. Let us come to deal with this demon of poverty. By the end of this Friday, this week, we'll finish Friday. Friday, it is when we'll finish this prayer. So your life will never be the same again. I'm telling you, this poverty must go. Poverty must die. You can't live such a life anymore. God has promised. Look at the book of Genesis. God has promised that Abraham will be blessed, even the family of this nation. You will be blessed. Therefore, people of God, don't live in poverty. Don't live in the life of poverty. God has not meant you to be poor. That's not God. It is the enemy, your enemy, the devil. That's make people to be poor. God has pressed us so much. Therefore, people of God, call me. I will break those powers of poverty. I will destroy them. God will give you opportunity of business, of doing some great things that will bring you wealthy. Remember, the wealthy will never depart from your house. Now you don't have wealth, you don't have riches because it has departed. I am praying that God will restore back wherever has taken them. It will come back in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi, saying bye-bye to you. See you tomorrow midnight, 12 midnight. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.